Are you laying on the ground?
Gotta show you something first.
We got another set plates. And also, we got 45s, we got 50s.
I mean, that's pretty cool.
I think we're all good. We're all warmed up.
So, the first exercise is going to be flat dumbbell flies. Really just getting a good stretch and contraction at the top because that's pretty crucial in some different training methods. I know I do that sometimes with chest, get blood flow into the muscle first at the beginning of the workout, just so you can feel the contraction in some other reps and exercises. So as you can tell, I'm going to do a voiceover for this video. Just with the music in the background, I don't want to get copyrighted yet again. So that's pretty much why I'm doing this. I also enjoy it because I get to, talk to you instead of you just watching it. So it's easier for you to interpret what I'm doing and why. But I did a few sets of this, like I said, blood flow, and then I'll move on to the compound. And one thing you will see me do is warm up my lats, and that's because your lats are very crucial in the sense of pressing off of them. Because that's what you're lying on your back. You're laying on your back and pressing off that. In addition to that, I want to say that it's important that you... I recommend starting out with the bar because that's what I do. And it's just a comfortability thing. Just getting used to the path of the bar and the movement.
Those are the new ones we got.
At JP Morgan, the only definition
of happiness
is yours. So bring us your questions about safety.
For my flat bench, I was doing 135 as the weight for all my working sets. I'd say I did like 4x8 with that, but like superset in between with pull downs.
I got some demons over the wall, let me tell you.
So you're just, yeah.
And I was thinking recently that my brother should get some footage around, the gym. I asked him for some help with that, and he did a pretty good job. So I just figured that'd be a good idea, getting some different angles on some exercises, see the depth, see the range of motion that I'm getting. So I thought that'd be a good idea and tried it. So yeah. And I figured, of course, I'd get some upper chest work because I need that development. Because I really have, like, you know, the lower chest developed because I do gymnastics and we do lots of dips. So that's just, and also genetics. It's just how I'm built, really. See, I'm built different. Anyway, that's what I'm working on. I did like 3 working sets with this. I think it was like maybe 95 pounds. So that's what I worked with. I'm working on heavier weight, so just getting good depth and range of motion.
This one's super hot. It feels like so weird.
Okay.
But I don't know. Yeah, bench is also not the best, like grip. Both grip and stability.
I figured I'd get one or two more sets like recorded to show you guys if I'm fatigued or not, because that's a big factor in your workouts too. If you're doing too many reps or have like the weight isn't the right weight, then that can really show too. And you can reflect on that, look back at the workout, see what you did wrong. So yeah. Oh man, look what I found, Mason doing incline, what a surprise. But yeah, here I am doing incline again, repping out. I think these are just the 45s, I'm not sure. Just because I want to get the, like, this is a high volume day, as you can see, because this is the second incline exercise I'm doing. This is just like more freedom, instead of just having a bar in your hands. So you can move the weight as you like, and incline can really build strength, but flat bench proves that strength. I'd say 4x12 on incline, at least for this, because like I said, you can move the weight as you like, make the comfortability, any changes too. So I'm starting to like incline dumbbell a lot more. I don't know why I didn't in the past. I like it more. Like I said, more range of motion can be, you know, displayed on this exercise. So yeah, I don't frown upon this exercise whatsoever.
Okay.
So I'm editing the video right now, and it's not even Christmas Day anymore. It's like the 29th or something, but I'm trying to get this video out before the new year. And a lot of people ask me the question, how are you so big? And the answer is just simply
eat a lot.
Well, this is a little bit of a haul. I remember every year, my brother gets one of these calendars. Oh man, that was a gift from my dad this year. But yeah, you got all the other ones on the back, so it's a whole calendar. You already know. You might see this. I got this. It's pretty cool. Saint Christopher. He was like a saint for
for he was considered a god, you know, through helping travelers, and he would help people cross this dangerous river. And he was wondering one day, when he was carrying a kid on his back, he was like, oh, this is getting heavier and heavier. The kid was saying that it's from all the people that you help across the river.
Bingo!
Keeping my room clean is a big struggle, you know, and that's for me. But, yeah, roll the clip of Christmas Day. This could take a while.
Nope. It's not a good quality.
A few moments later.
It's nuts.
Last clip was me just doing 135, warming up, still this, getting used to the weight, warming up my legs, because this is the first, like, this compound with 185. Here's me doing 225. My brother and I are working up to a heavy single today, and that felt really good. You know, after doing volume after a while, you can hit a heavy single. So... that felt surprisingly good, as you can see me nodding my head, but yeah, I'm gonna go up even heavier. Goal is 3 plates, so. I don't even think this is on Spotify or Apple Music. It's just, I go to YouTube, you know, it really gets me going. So David Lee put me on this song. So, yeah.
You guys don't understand the amount of frustration I had, you know, flowing through my head. Because my brother uses that, the one, like, the hole, the notch that above that I use. You see where I drop the bar? So we have to move the bar every single time, up and down. Change the weight, up and down, up and down.
You'll most likely see me doing beltless work. I know I have a belt on right here, but anything lighter than this, if I'm squatting, I'm not using a belt just because I don't want to get robbed from my like posterior chain. I want to be able to get abdominal pressure and keep a good core, like brace that.
Nah, bro, when it's just me, I'd be firing up a storm.
All right, cut that out.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Let's go. Come on. There it is. Come on. Come on. Oh yeah. Come on. One more.
No.
My brother and I decided we're not doing RDLs with the barbell, just because dumbbells. Like I said earlier in the vlog. That it's more freedom, really, and it doesn't take up as much space. They're easier to, you know, switch out, switch the weight. So we figured that'd be more efficient. We did those a couple reps with that.
I didn't cut my hair. Holy shit.
Okay.